I hear noises, ping noises in my head. Well, it's basically just Linux starting up, or Linux Mint for that in that matter, because we're going to talk about something that I find really, really interesting. Is Linux Mint a distribution or a respin? Before we dive into that, I want to clarify some things. So if I can get up to good old Firefox and do paint.net. So let's clarify my definition of a distribution. You're making a box. A distribution is if most of the software or most of the things that are evolving around the distribution is coming from inside the development house themselves. Arch Linux is a good example. Debian is a good example. Even Ubuntu is a good example. I'll go into that later on. SUSE is a good example. Red Hat is a good example. They control the repos. They control the software. Most or all of the software. They are not reliant or minimum reliant on third-party people. So this would be like if we take Kubuntu. Kubuntu is a respin in my eyes because it's heavily depending on Ubuntu. It's basically just Ubuntu with another desktop on it. So if we make a new square here, and we make a bigger one here, that would basically mean that for something like a respin, it would mean that they are taking heavily from this box, and then they are doing some stuff themselves. This here is what I would call a respin. They are relying a lot on third party or other people's work, or they would not exist without other people's work. So like I said, Kubuntu could not exist without Ubuntu. It would not be there because it's, like I said, it's just sprinkled on top of Ubuntu. Sorian is the same. What else can I use as an example here? Farin OS is the same. Easy Archer is the same. Storm OS is the same. You get what I'm saying here. So I'm what my distinction is between a respin and a distribution is, how much reliant are they on other people's work? Are they controlling all the repositories themselves? How big of a amount of the repositories and software are in the project's control? The less there is, the more of a respin they are and less of a distribution they are. Another way of looking at the distribution is that how independent is it? So let's go into it when I'm done these definitions. Because I'm crazy like that. So let's go into good old, I think, Synaptic is a really good way of looking at this. Because we're just looking at repositories. It's a really simple way to gauge if a distribution is independent or a respin. Meaning that they are basing most, like 80-90% of their work on other people's work. And they have no control over it. They are not doing anything with it. They're just basically yanking it down, putting it in, spewing it out on an ISO. So let's go into Linux Mint's repos here. Well, anything that says Jamie or Jamie is basically Ubuntu. Already we have 13, almost 14,000 packages. All of this is Ubuntu. I think this is Ubuntu also. Let's say this is Linux Mint. This is what Linux Mint is doing. Linux Mint. So 200 packages in this one. 2,000 something in this one here. This is also Ubuntu. So this is not Linux Mint. This is, you can see it on the package version here. This says Linux Mint on them. Or the code name for it. So this is also an Ubuntu one. This is also an Ubuntu one. So actually, we only have this one, and this one. So 204, let's round up. 204, but that's what that one. 206. Let's say 1,200. Yeah, let's just round up. So 1,200 packages out of 70,425. That's not a lot. So that means that from a package standpoint, how many packages are Mint controlling? Or how big of a part of the operating system is Mint controlling or fiddling with or mantling with is under 1%. So is Linux Mint the Ubuntu version, not the Debian edition, but the Ubuntu version, because there's a lot of you guys out there that would go after me for that. Is it really an independent distribution, or is it a modified version of Ubuntu or a respin of Ubuntu with their own desktop on it? You can decide that. I know what I would call it, but I will let you decide that. If we take Ubuntu, they control all of the repos, all of the software, meaning that they either modify or can modify all of the source packages for those source files, and they are curating, controlling what's going in and out of the repos. Yes, they do take it from Debian, stable testing, and set, and make those repos. But they still have to do that. And merge it together, mix it together to make Ubuntu work the way it does. Mint is doing is that they're taking 99% of Ubuntu and more or less leave it be and only focusing on the 1%. It's a big 1%. It's the desktop, as you guys see here. You know, the good old desktop we have. They have Firefox, they implement Firefox. We have a lot of things, you know, their update manager down here, if I can actually. There you go, buddy. You know, their updates manager. So they have a lot of tools and they have a lot of small, minute programs that they control, they make, they modify. They are basically the master of the universe too, but not 70 or 69,300-ish or 200-ish packages. It's something they don't mess with, they don't control, they don't do anything with. So would you regard this as a distribution, aka an independent running version of Linux, or a fork or respin of Ubuntu? And I know a lot of people say, oh, well, this is not an indication of how independent it is. It kind of is. Because if you take those 69,000 packages plus away from Mint, you basically deactivate all of these repos here. That's Ubuntu. This version of Mint would be nothing. The Mint Debian edition will, but that's not the distribution or the version of Mint we're talking about today. It's the mainline distribution that's use Ubuntu as its base. So if we rip that away, we basically only have the candy flossing left. We only have the fairy dust sprinkling left. And is it... Would you call that a distribution or respin? Out from my definition of a respin and distribution, you may have another one. But I think that mine is somewhat fair. I think mine is a good way of looking at the distinctions between, are we respinning other people's work, respin, or are we making our own distribution? If you know what I think, leave it down below, and I'll see you all later. Have an amazing day. Bye-bye.